And so if you like this video, please be sure to leave a like. It means the world to me. If you don't agree with what I'm saying, rather than a dislike, I'd really appreciate if you just leave a comment down below, because I'm not in it for the monetization or the stats or anything. Like, I want to know what you feel I'm doing wrong. Some of us enjoy shopping, and to enjoy an activity like that means inevitably you're gonna have a build up of clothes and shoes. And what builds up directly with that? How many girls wanna the amount of packaging you have. Some people are fine with stacking their shoeboxes on shoeboxes until they're trapped in their cage of hype that they'll never be able to rotate enough, or people will never know they own a Travis AJ1. Sometimes I don't let go. Because today they rotated to the Ultra Boost 4D, 3D printed ass recliner ass shoes. Now if you're anything like me, you're not a fan of hoarding all those boxes. Maybe you don't like to keep your shoes in the box as it's an unneeded obstacle. You just want to put your shoes on. You don't want to have to lift a few boxes and figure out what is what. So what do you do? Who wants to be a millionaire? A. Smash the box. B. Throw the boxes in the recycling bin. No garbage. C. Hold on to them in case you decide to resell your shoes. D. Find a creative way to use them as memorabilia. The correct answer is all of them but C. Why? Because first of all, when I crop, I don't allow myself to feel any doubt so that I would end up choosing money over what I thought I would actually want to own. So I get rid of the box and tags. There's no way that I can feel pressured or tempted. Find a way to style them. There was a reason you wanted them. Don't just sell them. Now why the others? A, I already have an Air Force box here, and so who needs this one? B, the polar bears need my help, so I mean, I gotta recycle that, why not? It's all cardboard anyway. There's generally no items on that box that shouldn't be able to be recycled. And D, the serious part of why I've made this video. Creating the memorabilia can be as simple as cutting the box for any parts you've seen as significant, or parts of the bag even. It's about making it become a flat item which you can use just like a poster. If you're someone who doesn't really like the idea of having another human's face on your wall as well, this is perfect. Now I've done it really rough in my own room, but that's because of how I am. If you want a better aesthetic or you want it to be a little smoother, go ahead. Besides from giving you something to do with your packaging, you're still able to show others who do come and visit your room, since you are a hype beast and you do like to show off that you've had these products or you have shopped here before. And so if you want to make a smooth aesthetic as you go along, maybe you can align it with colors as I've tried to do here. As I'm the first draft and the rough copy, I think it's fair to say you guys should let me off with just how rough it is. Thank you. The reason you might want to consider this is if you look deep within yourself, you've got to ask, do you feel like you buy these products because of the hype? Yes, I do. That is why I am dubbed a hype beast. But what does it mean to be a hype beast? I feel like by destroying the packaging, I acknowledge that it's just an item of clothing, and that the materialistic packaging that I received it in does not act as a symbol of my identity or my social ranking, and it's just a construct. I have power over the clothing by being able to destroy what the clothing once came in. By not being held down by what the labels I wear may have me think about myself, or to link my self-value to the item and how much an item's worth. If you go ahead and buy £500 D-squared shoes, you might feel inclined to keep the box. You've spent £500 on it. You feel like, huh, yeah, I'm the man. That is why you've bought them for £500. However, once I had destroyed the box, they became just shoes again. Maybe not everyone suffers from this, but if there's even a few of you who understand where I'm coming from here, and you relate to that oddly specific feeling of feeling like maybe you buy hype to feel noticed, or better than others who once doubted you, like a villain's origin story, and then this should help liberate you of clutter physically, but also mentally and emotionally, helping that hype beast within you feel more beast and more hype. Also, you know, what you gotta do though is to make sure no packaging is exempt, Once you start, you can't allow something to have more value than another. I can't let my Yeezy Alien feel any better than my white Air Forces. They're all shoes end of the day. I like the design, however I cannot let the perceived value hold me down. Sometimes though, I hold onto a bag or two if it offers functionality. But beyond that, always remember the purpose of the item was to wear and enjoy your life in, not to hold and store your self-worth in. If your shoes aren't going in the box and you're not stacking them, get rid of the box. Because the only thing that box will be holding is your self-worth and confidence. I hope this helps with helping you decide what you should do with your clothes packaging once you're done with it, or your sneaker packaging. Hopefully it gives you an even more creative idea. If someone does it, please let me know. Tag me in it. I'm going to create an Instagram account specifically for the channel, just to interact with you guys, because I've noticed your comments down below. I've noticed who comes maybe frequently or regularly, and I respect and love you and appreciate you for it. And I want to be able to interact with you guys as we work together to, you know, really talk about fashion and enjoy what it is.